What's the YouTube gang shit going on? I'm reacting to the DMB Nation calling out. I am Dante and a couple other YouTubers, which in my opinion is corny as hell, because it's like a super squadron of them, and I can't even take them serious for real.
So much that we all moved down here to be one squad. Stop running like my brother, my
every, let me get that focus, but every 15 to 10 minutes they stop the video to give hype. What was that? Hype intervals. I can't take them serious because they're all ranging from, I'm gonna say, just for safety reasons, 17 to 30. Probably being generous. But 17 to 30 were, they were born in the late 80s to early 90s. And they're self-made, which you should know how to carry yourself at around that age where, yeah, it's YouTube where the standard not so high, but to get hype in the camera constantly, just cheesy and corny. I'm already 5 minutes into this. Just one black meme. I remember I was watching H3, and they talked about black digital face. I didn't watch the whole video, but I saw that title and I watched like 10, probably 20 seconds of it, literally. And that's all they're doing. They're just making a meme generation, so you can't really take them serious. Their whole thing is everybody finds everything fake. The girl right there in the black, my little sister watches. She like 5. I seen her, so that's how I seen her. And her content is quite enjoyable to me because I ain't subscribing or nothing, but it's entertainment because then she does stuff to put the little baby in there, which I'm not trying to bring no these kids into it. I'm just saying she uses the kid making slime, being a good parent or role model or wherever she is at, because I only started making slime once. But as far as that, I mean, to constantly want to be a part of bullshit and drama, and every time I look up, I'm subscribed to DMB Nation, every time I look up their clickbait titles, we can't go through this, or I can't believe, like, it's just clickbait. I got saw some shit. Fuck Instagram and all that. I got real clout where I can go anywhere I want, do anything I want. I mean, fuck the internet shit. Clout for me personally is when you can do what the fuck you want, when the fuck you want. Fame, starstruck, 15 minutes, it don't mean nothing. I got clout in the city. Like, I got clout in my city.
I like how you gave 150,000 subs off of this. So I hope maybe the next 40,000 or whatever you get keeps.
Well, like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Share the video. Help a nigga blow up off of this. Yeah.
You satisfied with the rest of the year because we spent money over here. Hey, 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 bro, yo, serious, I'm putting you on so long, man. What, yo, huh? Yo, serious, that money is your money, yo. Hey, I'm gonna take it.
The reality is, the way they talk, I know they try to probably dress Ayanate, where he don't seem like the flash type where he care about belts and all that. Name, you know, just started rocking belts that we want to be for real. Like, they just started buying ice off of a rap check. Paraphrasing. Where Ayanate been doing this for a good minute. So if he really wanted to rock belts and Gucci Louis lowers, he can do that. Yeah, let me get back to some other video. I think the manager needs her own personal YouTube. I understand what she's trying to do by bringing all her clientele in, but if you can't have adults who are going to take the situation of it's their pride on the line, essentially. Nobody else's. If they can take themselves serious, how can we, as the viewers and the merch buyers? Make sure you follow them on Instagram at @sauce_Osama_Shabazz. I'm gonna put that out there in the middle of the video. Since they even got a 30 with a 30, this nigga swear he's Superman, bro. Come on, chill the fuck out. We dropped the Eddie. These niggas ain't living their life. We all fucking YouTubers. I don't gotta do this YouTube. See, I can quit today. I can flex on the gram every fucking day. I ain't never had a check off this shit. So I don't need this shit. But when you make tens of thousands of dollars, hundreds of thousands of dollars, and try to flex like you drew a rich hood rich, when the fact of the matter is you going through a drought like everybody else going through a drought. You may not show it because you got other things on the table lined up, but you going through a drought like everybody else going through a drought. You making videos for a living. You're not really sniper gang, you know? They're dissing him, but she's saying, I would have loved to work. You could have reached out to this man before it got to this escalation. You could have brought him around. I'm rocking with Ayanate. You watch this video and I get some views. Hit up Ayanate. Tell him to hit me up at @sauce_Osama_Shabazz, where me and him can put some shit in the works, because I fuck with him. Dog, look at this hunky bitch in the background. Dog, get that hunky bitch on somewhere, man. Fuck that bitch.
Can be, and you need off the prison queen? Let's get it. Let's go. We can do some great things for you. Also, Troy's TV, I see that 57,000. I can get you to 100,000.
I ain't never heard of Troy TV. I'm gonna check him out. But since the big three, four, MLG, and all that, talking shit, I mean, they're not saying fuck him, they're not saying he a bitch or a hoe, because whatever reason. So I gotta look up these other two people. I don't say I fuck with him, y'all. I follow him because he genuinely funny and I see myself in the gig. it's not just somebody's mother or anything like that. The disrespect comes into play when you put yourself in your clientele's business. I mean, it's not the 90s where the manager has to be in the videos, the manager has to be the background dancer, the manager has to be essentially a part of the show. Where is you as a manager should take pride in what you're doing, your craft. I mean, in my personal opinion, you probably never studied for that shit. You never strove to be a manager. They probably, you be making probably, yeah, you like Bianca's stepmom, and you probably manage some low budget retail store, which my mom has done, and I mean, you're nothing too special. I'm not putting a passion because she's getting you to your final goal, which is more subs, more views, more money. But like I said, it's not the 90s where you have to have your manager in every aspect every day. I just noticed it was a baby in the background, and like it's been there for a solid man to stand behind the manager, and they doing all this hooping, hollering, and cussing. I mean, I'm no saint when it comes to kids, but you would think that they would at least try to remain calm and mild mannered.
People's time, because say that jump to all of us, bro. Because I really with that, dog. Oh, my brother, with that,
dog. Why do YouTube videos? Are you really with the shits? I mean, anything that makes you a clout chaser, which in turn makes you a hypocrite. Yeah, I'm gonna stop the video right there. Because, I mean, I'm following the reaction to Dante and see what his thoughts are. But, yeah, DMB Nation and the manager's clientele. I personally think that it's being hypocritical, but I'm out. Peace. My Instagram is all throughout the video. Deuces.